HPV Vaccination Week is next week, and we have Ian here from Southeast Idaho Public Health to tell us what you guys are doing to help get people vaccinated.
Connor, thanks so much for having me on. Mm-hmm. So HPV, there's a fantastic vaccine out there that really does an excellent job of preventing cervical cancers.
Okay.
And unfortunately in Idaho, there hasn't been much uptake. Our kids are not getting vaccinated the way they are in other parts of the country and in other parts of the world with this new vaccine. And really, I mean, this vaccine has the potential to make cervical cancer basically a thing of the past. It reduces the incidence of cervical cancer by like 80% with this new vaccine. In Idaho, we have a couple cases every year in southeastern Idaho.
Really?
About 50 cases in the state every year at least. And unlike breast cancer, which is usually quite treatable, cervical cancer has a very high mortality rate.
Okay.
It's the reason that anyone gets pap smears. If everyone got vaccinated, pap smears might be a thing of the past.
That's very interesting. And so who should be getting these vaccines?
Both boys and girls.
Okay.
It can also cause cancers in boys as well. And so boys and girls starting at age 11. So really, in Idaho, the HPV vaccine is not required for entering school, like the Tdap vaccine or meningococcal vaccine. And you know, that's maybe one reason that most people don't get it, because they see that it's not required and they think, maybe it's not something that's really recommended. It absolutely is.
But it is.
Yeah.
And then if people want to get vaccinated, how can they do that next week?
So the health department has 8 locations in southeastern Idaho, and all of our locations have HPV vaccine. We also are happy to answer any questions that people might have about the vaccine. Also, many private provider offices will also have HPV vaccine.
Okay.
So I would just reach out to your primary care provider or reach out to Southeastern Idaho Public Health.
Okay, perfect. Well, thank you so much for coming on, Ian.
Thanks for having me.
And still to come, we take a look at your KPVI News Today headlines.